Hello, welcome to part 8, our series on designing two-story residential building. So okay na tayo last time sa columns. Next natin ngayon is footing design using STAAD RCDC. Okay, so open tayo ng RCDC. Okay. Project two story residential client. Okay, yun, and then choose the right footing. Now on footing design, yung RCDC is medyo limited siya on foundation design. So pag isolated lang, okay siya, pwede siyang gamitin, reliable. Pero pag darating ka na sa mga combined, eccentric or cantilever, mat, raft, pile, meron tayong STAAD Advanced, STAAD Foundation Advance. So, yun yung mas capable. So, dito naman sa project na to, wala namang all footing will be considered isolated. So, pwede natin gamitin. Okay? So, again, ito na yung interface natin sa RCDC. Start tayo sa settings. General. Okay. Design setting. So, of course, net yung gagamitin natin as soil bearing capacity. Okay. Tignan natin lagyan yan. Provide top steel. Tignan yan. Okay. So, net soil bearing capacity. Nakikita yan sa soil test. Now, if walang soil test pa na data, conservative na naman, assume tayo ng 190 or 100. Okay. So, 100 lagay natin dyan. Initially, soil. Okay. Pwede yung 18. Founding depth natin is 1.2. Okay. Water table, 10. Then, permissible loss of contact. So, ito yung contact na ina-allow natin na, meaning, inaalaw natin yung footing na pag gumalaw siya, inaalaw tayo ng hindi siya didikit ng 100% sa soil if ever may movement. So, 30 lang ganyan. 10. Concrete, 3,000 PSI, steel grade, grade 60, clear cover for subject to soil. Or exterior, 75. Type of soil, okay. Earthquake, soil bearing capacity increase. Nag-a-allow yung code na increase tayo ng 30%. 33%. Sa soil bearing capacity. When? For earthquake and wind. Okay. Okay na. Okay. Okay. So, dito tayo sa reinforcement settings. Yan. Minimum bottom steel. 16 na lang gamitin natin. Top. Hindi natin na-provide sa top. Maximum 16 na din. Yan. Okay. Then, tayo sa loadings. EX, earthquake X, earthquake Z, dead load, live load. So, bam. Then, as you can see here, sa footing, kasi dalawa tayo. Dalawa yung gagamitin nating load combinations. So, sa sizing, service load combination ang gagamitin natin sa design, yun yung ultimate. So, at from analysis pa rin, yan, yun yung ultimate loading combinations. Then, sa sizing, at from analysis, yan. Yan na yung sa sizing. Okay? Click okay. Basically, yun na yun. Then, design, auto-design, boom! So, automatic siya nag-generate. Okay? So, yun. Yun naman yung design natin dito is purely isolated footing. So, yan. Again, pwede mo na itong portion na to, pwede mo ma-save sa CAD. Then, ito na rin yung gagamitin mong gagamitin sa plan as footing, as foundation plan. Okay? Then, yung iba nating menus dito is reports. Again, meron pa rin tayong footing schedule. Hindi lumabas. Yung. Okay. So, ayan na yan. Naka-tabulate na dyan lahat. Sizes. Both, main reinforcement along width, along length. Okay. With the spacing. Dyan na. Okay. Then, meron sa report. Meron ding drawing na nakalagay. Let's say, ito yung kunin natin. This is 5. Footing 5. Yung pinakamalaki. Okay. Check natin. Yun. So, ito yung detail ng footing 5. Ka-drawing na dyan lahat. And with the corresponding rebar schedule. Yan. Okay. Then, again, same sa mga previews. Meron tayong design calculations. And bill of quantities. Meron ding, syempre, bar packing schedule. Okay? So, that's how we design footing using STAAD RCDC. So, again, in previous video siguro, I'll be having a series, separate series on STAAD Foundation Advance. So, yun, di-discuss natin doon about designing combined, cantilever, eccentric, smart footing, etc. Okay? Thank you.